The cream of the crop! Nobody does it better!
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Fly, and we gotta talk about Luffy after Wano. Originally, I wanted to talk about all the Straw Hats and what's gonna happen after Wano, but I think Luffy is the MC, so I believe that he deserves a video of his own. We might do separate videos for each of the characters individually, as well as some of the supernovas like Law and Kid, if they even survive the war in Wano. Oda has set up the war in Wano to be one of the biggest battles that he has ever set up in the history of One Piece thus far. And we know that the end of Wano is gonna mark the beginning of the end of One Piece, as Oda himself has stated as such. This war is supposed to make the Marineford War look small and cute in comparison, and the status quo and the world at large is gonna be very, very different by the end of this war, and there will be probably a new era afoot. We may even lose a Yonko by the end of the war. Maybe even two, with Big Mom and Kaido falling, but I doubt they're both falling in Wano because it's not Big Mom's time just yet. I think her story ends at Elbaf or in Fishman Island. I talked about that in a previous video. But nonetheless, the scope of the One Piece world is going to be drastically different, and there's going to be a vacuum in power at the end of Wano. Whether Kaido loses or dies, at the end of this battle, his reputation among the world is going to be tarnished. During this battle, I highly expect to see a lot of power-ups and new abilities that people are gonna show, such as Luffy. We're probably gonna see a new gear, and it's quite possible that he may even awaken his devil fruit during this war. He might not master it, but he might trigger it and find a way to awaken his devil fruit. It'll be really cool seeing Luffy bounce around like Bellamy and turning his environment into rubber, kind of similar to Gentle from My Hero, where maybe Luffy might even be able to turn the very air itself into rubber. The velocity and speed and the ricocheting of him going bouncing off it all over the place is going to give him a great power boost. Imagine him in Gear 4th just bouncing around and then hitting you at full speed. It's going to be nuts. Even in Gear 3rd, that's going to be a great power boost, him bouncing around from his, as well as he's going to get a power up in Haki, and his Haki ability is going to be flourishing and be much more powerful than compared to when he's first got into Wano. As we've seen in the Prisoner Mines when he's training Ryo, there's no doubt in my mind by the end of Wano that Luffy's going to be a very, very considerably powerful person, and everyone throughout the world and even the fan base might finally consider Luffy as a fifth emperor of the sea, where through his trials and tribulations, his power is going to boost and finally earning himself the title of emperor, because not a lot of people in the fan base really think Luffy deserves the title of fifth emperor or even his bounty. They believe it's a bit too much praise, and it's finally time for Luffy to prove his worth of being an emperor, or at least having the power to go against an emperor. He's probably most likely not gonna defeat or fight Kaido one-on-one. Well, he's gonna fight Kaido one-on-one, but he will lose, and he's not gonna defeat Kaido one-on-one. It's gonna be in a group effort, I'm certain of that. But by the end of Wano, we're definitely going to look at Luffy as a different character as a whole, and he will prove that he can truly hang and tangle with the best of them. Because it's only going to get tougher in the future with Akainu and the world government being enemies, as well as Blackbeard looming over the horizon. By the end of Wano, after this war, Luffy will be one step closer to Pirate King, not only in power, but also in status. Because once the Wano arc is over, and Luffy gets himself the third Poneglyph, Luffy has 3/4 of the Poneglyphs and will only need one more for him to be able to reach Laugh Tail. And unless someone is able to steal the rubbings of the Road Poneglyphs, as well as Robin, who can read the Poneglyphs, Luffy's on a fast track to becoming Pirate King, and it's gonna be a lot sooner rather than later. And I believe after this arc, we're gonna be heading into the search for the final Poneglyph. Luffy and Shanks' meeting is also probably not that far off either, as Shanks himself, when he was reading the newspaper about Luffy becoming the fifth emperor of the sea and is getting his bounty increase, Shanks did say that our time of meeting is soon. During the Battle of Onigashima, when Luffy encounters Kaido once again, I do believe that we're gonna get a new form of Gear 4th. I don't believe that Luffy's gonna have a Gear 5th, or at least not yet, not until maybe like later on, like against Blackbeard or something, but I do believe that he's gonna get new forms of Gear 4th. We might get a Tiger Man, we might even get a Dragon Man, which will probably utilize his new form of Haki, Ryo, and his advanced techniques. King of Lightning made a video about this, about Luffy's new Gear 4 Tiger Man. You should definitely check it out, it's a good listen. Luffy is known for coming up with off-the-cuff, on-the-spot techniques and forms. So a new Gear 4th is definitely very, very highly possible, especially against Kaido, with Luffy having all these weeks and days to prepare this battle. But I think Tiger would make a lot of sense if Luffy came up with a Tiger Man and fought Kaido, because in Chinese lore, the four symbols, the White Tiger of the West, the Azure Dragon of the East, the Black Tortoise of the North, and the Vermilion Bird, aka the Phoenix, of the South. And guess what? We have both the Dragon and the Phoenix currently on Wano, respectively being Kaido and Marco. There's been a theory going on for the years that the four symbols of the four guardians represented the Yonko, with the White Tiger and the Azure Dragon both being Kaido and Whitebeard, as they're seen to be rivals, or at least have a large distaste. And Luffy using Tiger Man against Kaido could be a representation of that, as Luffy and Kaido are enemies. At the end of Whole Cake Island, whether people want to agree with the end result between Katakuri and Luffy, it's been shown that Luffy could at least go toe-to-toe with the First Division Commander. So by the end of Wano, I think we can only progress and Luffy should be able to go toe-to-toe with a Yonko, kind of, maybe? I don't know. During the raid of Onigashima, Luffy has been seen to casually go in and out of Gear 4th, like when he went to go attack the ships alongside Kid and Law. Luffy went into Gear 4th, as well as when he was about to fight Ulti, who's just about to go into Gear 4th. So after Wano, I think Luffy's going to be able to master Gear 4th, or at least be very, very close. And Luffy's stamina weakness while using Gear 4th might disappear, or at least his duration where he can go into Gear 4th might be extended, and he can stay in Gear 4th for a lot longer time, and maybe the depletion after, when he can't use Haki after he uses Gear 4th, might be short or altogether disappear. In terms of power, besides upgrading his Haki and awakening his Devil Fruit, the only real next step for Luffy I see is making his rubber body more malleable, sort of like Mr. Fantastic or Plastic Man from DC Comics. The things that Luffy has done with his Devil Fruit is outstanding and very creative, and if not, he's one of the best rubber users in literature history, in my opinion. But unlike Mr. Fantastic from Marvel Comics, he has never really changed his body or used his rubber to form weapons, like making a mace out of his hand and doing all sorts of silly stuff and using his elasticity and his rubber to its full extent. Oda might not actually ever go to that extent where Luffy uses his rubber and elasticity to its full extent, to the point where Luffy's able to form weapons with his rubber body and manipulate it, sort of like making his hand turn into a mace, not an actual weapon, but in the shape of one at least. Back in Thriller Bark, Maria was able to steal Luffy's shadow and put it into Oars, and then use that shadow and manipulate Oars' body at will, like turning Oars' body into a rubber ball. Luffy has never really done that, manipulating the rubber to that extent and forming these objects and shapes in different forms. And finally, the next step for Luffy after Wano is that he will probably upgrade and evolve his Conqueror's Haki. Similar to Whole Cake Island and Wano, where Whole Cake, Luffy upgraded his Observation Haki and learned how to use Future Sight, albeit not as good as Katakuri. And in Wano, Luffy learned Ryo, where he's able to use his Haki and attack the inside of a person's body. So the next step is obviously Conqueror's Haki. How Luffy upgrades that or learns how to better it as beyond me. Maybe he'll learn it in Elbaf, which I think is going to be the next big island arc, because that's been foreshadowed since before Alabasta. But it seems that Conqueror's Haki, at least the higher level of Conqueror's Haki, is able to manipulate the environment around them. Not only does Conqueror's Haki allow you to knock out people with weak wills, or at least weaker wills than the user, basically taking out all the fodder, but we've also seen some higher levels of Conqueror's Haki, such as when Shanks entered or walked on Whitebeard's ship, he was damaging the ship itself, and then when they clashed, the sky split. The exact same thing happened back on Onigashima when Kaido and Big Mom clashed and the sky split. And then there was the Mirror World when Katakuri and Luffy were having their Conqueror's Haki clash. The ground around them was breaking apart. And how could I forget that Conqueror's Haki also allows you to tame wild animals, as seen when Luffy tamed the Kraken as well as Duval's Buffalo pre-time skip, which was the first time we saw Luffy even activate Conqueror's Haki. So upgrading and evolving Conqueror's Haki should allow Luffy the ability to affect the immediate environment that he's around, but will allow him to have greater control over the ability, maybe allowing him to pinpoint where exactly which area he wants to affect. The way this Conqueror's Haki is used in affecting the environment kind of reminds me of spiritual pressure back in Bleach. For anyone that watched Bleach, they used to use their spiritual pressure to affect the environment as well as other people and making them forced to kneel before them, kind of like making their own gravity
and making it a lot more heavier, which could be what hockey, or my bad, a Conqueror's hockey could be, where it increases the gravity for certain people. I don't know, I'm just spitballing, it's probably not true, but it does remind me of spiritual pressure and Ryotsu. There's been a theory going around that Conqueror's hockey, or at least peak Conqueror's hockey, the highest form of it, allows the user to manipulate time, such as what Shanks does, what people believe. And this came from One Piece Pirate Warriors 2 or 3, I believe, when Shanks got the ability to slow down time. And because we never seen Shanks fight, people saw that and go, oh, he can manipulate time now because he does it in the game. And they kind of ran with it. But I'm kind of digressing. We need to go back to Luffy. Now, I don't think that Conqueror's hockey is going to go that far, but there is a possibility, I guess, which would be kind of dope. You really never know with Oda. Anyways, guys, that's the video. Don't forget to rate the video, subscribe, and click the bell icon to stay notified. Also, put down in the comments what you think of Luffy and what will happen to him after Wano. After Wano, Luffy will single-handedly be the closest man to the One Piece, because not only would he have 3/4 of the road poneglyph, he also has Robin who can read the poneglyph. So Luffy is well on his way to becoming Pirate King, and it's going to be a lot sooner than later than we all assume. And hopefully after this arc, Luffy could finally be considered Emperor, even though he is by some people part of the world. I mean, like, actually considered by, like, the fan base, where everyone's like, yeah, his status is earned and he can finally keep up and go toe-to-toe with the big boys. Anyways, I hope you guys have a good day and a good night. I will catch you guys on the next video. Toodles!